Right, we're gonna start again, family. Hold on a minute, let me get this right. Hold on a second. Right, that's it. So we're about to start again. We've never felt so much, we've never seen so many hardened hearts as today. It's more than York, more than Hull. It's unbelievable. So please pray. Your prayers are so powerful. God answers prayers. Remember that. Pray for all these people, please. God doesn't want them to perish. He doesn't want them to be left behind, but it's their choice. Please pray that they'd make the right choice.
Amen. God bless you, Whitby. We've come not to judge you, not to condemn you, but tell you the good news, the gospel, which is that there is everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord. The Bible says we all have sinned, and we all fall short of the glory of God. And the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is everlasting life through Jesus Christ. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, that whosoever should believe on him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Your body contains your soul, which will spend eternity in one of two places, heaven or hell, and the choice is yours. It's not about religion, it's about believing in what Jesus did for us on the cross. He shed his blood for the forgiveness of all our sin, past, present, and future. He was buried, and on the third day, he rose again from the dead. You believe that truly in your heart, and call upon the name of Jesus, and you will be saved. Save yourselves from this untoward and wicked generation. Jesus loves you, but he will not force himself upon you. Please go to Jesus. He said, I will in no wise cast anyone away who goes to me. In truth, it doesn't matter what we have done. Jesus will forgive each and every one of us who goes to him. In truth, Christ died on the cross. The good shepherd gave his life for all of us on the cross. He shed his blood for the forgiveness of all our sins, past, present and future. He was buried in a tomb, and on the third day God raised him from the dead. When you believe that truly in your heart and call upon Jesus, you will be saved. Your name shall be written in heaven. You'll be safe from going down to hell, and you'll be given a place in heaven, a mansion in heaven. Who would not want that? The Bible says that God resists the proud, but he gives more grace to the humble. Humble yourselves. Be humble enough to say, yes, of course I have sinned. Of course I have broken God's commandments. We've all lied. We've all cheated. We've all done things that we shouldn't have. And the wages of all this sin is death. But the gift of God is everlasting life through Jesus Christ. Please, lay hold of your salvation. Do not take the gamble that heaven and hell are not real. Because they are. God wants you in heaven. And the only requirement for you to enter into heaven is to believe the gospel, the good news, that Jesus paid the penalty in full on the cross for all our sins, past, present and future. He was buried, and on the third day he rose again from the dead. That's the only requirement. And call upon him, you will be saved, and your name shall be written in heaven. Above you is the heavens. Do you want to go there? Or do you want to go to outer darkness, where there will be weeping, wailing, and gnashing of teeth, where the world never dies and the fire is never quenched? Go to Jesus. He will not turn anyone away who goes to him in truth. The thief, Satan, comes not but for to steal, to kill, and to destroy. But Jesus Christ has come that we might have life, and that we might have it more abundantly. He said, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd gave his life for the sheep on the cross. He shed his blood for the forgiveness of all our sins, past, present, and future. He was buried and rose again from the dead on the third day. The only requirement for you to enter into heaven and be saved is to believe on Jesus' death, his burial, and resurrection, and call upon him. It's called the simplicity that is in Jesus. God made it so simple that a little child could understand it. Because God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, that whosoever believes on him should not perish but have everlasting life. Fear whosoever, call upon Jesus, it doesn't matter what you've done. Please do not take the gamble that heaven and hell are not real, because they are. God wants you in heaven. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord Jesus Christ shall be saved. Jesus said, verily, verily, I say unto you, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. He will not see the kingdom of heaven. You are born again the moment you believe the gospel. First of all, the Bible says that we all have sinned. We've all broken God's commandments. And the wages of sin is death. But the gift of God is everlasting life through Jesus Christ. Christ paid the penalty in full on the cross for all our sins, past, present, and future. He shed his blood for all of us. He was buried. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. The only requirement for you to enter into heaven and be saved from going down to hell is to believe on Jesus' death, his burial, and resurrection on the cross, and call upon Jesus. Jesus said, I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. No man shall see the Father in heaven but through Jesus. Go to him, go to Jesus. He will not turn anyone away who goes to him in truth. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, Jesus, that whosoever believes in him should not perish but have everlasting life. Fear whosoever, call upon Jesus. Do not take the gamble that heaven and hell are not real. Your body contains your soul, which will spend eternity in one of two places, heaven or hell, and the choice is yours. It's not about religion, it's about believing on Jesus and what he did for us on the cross. Christ paid the penalty in full on the cross for all our sins, past, present, and future. He was buried, and on the third day, he rose again from the dead. The only requirement for you to enter into heaven and be saved is believe on Jesus, his death, his burial, and resurrection, and call upon him. For whosoever shall call upon the name of Jesus shall be saved. Please do not be so busy with your lives that you haven't got time for your Father in heaven, who loves you, who gave his only begotten Son, Jesus, that whosoever believes on Jesus should not perish, but have everlasting life. Please do not harden your hearts. Be humble enough to admit, yes, of course I have sinned, of course I have lied, of course I have cheated. We've all broken God's commandments, and the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is everlasting life through Jesus Christ. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord Jesus shall be saved. Dear whosoever, do not take the gamble that heaven and hell are not real, because they are. God wants you in heaven, for he's given you a choice, he's given you free will. I am not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ, because it is the power of God unto salvation for everyone that believes. The Bible is expressly clear. It says that we've all sinned, we've all broken God's commandments, and the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is everlasting life through Jesus Christ. For there is no other name under heaven given among men by which we must be saved. Jesus, he said, I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. Christ paid the penalty in full on the cross for all our sins, past, present, and future. He was buried, and on the third day he rose again from the dead. You believe that in your heart, call upon Jesus. It is the only requirement for you to enter into heaven and be saved from going down to hell. Please do not take the gamble that heaven and hell are not real. Your body contains your soul, which will spend eternity in one of two places, heaven or hell. The choice is yours. Jesus wants you in heaven. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord Jesus shall be saved. Jesus Christ said, I am the door. By me, if any man shall enter in, he shall be saved. Go to him. He will not turn anyone away who goes to him in truth. Be humble enough to confess, yes, of course I have sinned. We've all sinned. The wages of sin is death. But the gift of God is everlasting life through Jesus Christ. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, that whosoever believes on him should not perish in hell, but have everlasting life in the kingdom of heaven. For there is no other name under heaven given amongst men by which we must be saved. Jesus said, I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. No man shall see the Father in heaven but through Jesus. Go to him. It doesn't matter what we have done. He will receive each and every one of you when you go to him in truth. When you believe that Christ died for our sins on the cross, he was buried and rose again on the third day. You believe that truly in your heart and call upon the name of Jesus and you will be saved. The hour is late. The night is far spent. The day of Jesus is at hand. Jesus is about to descend from heaven with a shout in the voice of the archangel and the trumpet of God. He's going to gather up to heaven all who truly have believed and laid hold of their salvation by believing on Jesus' death, his burial and resurrection on the cross and calling upon him. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord Jesus shall be saved.
How long are we on now? 10 minutes, leave it off a bit longer.
For God so loved the world, God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, that whosoever believes on him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Be a whosoever, believe on the gospel, the good news, that there is everlasting life through Jesus Christ. Heaven and hell are real. Please do not take the gamble that heaven and hell are not real. Your body contains your soul, which will go to one or two places when you die, heaven or hell, and the choice is yours. The Bible says that we have all sinned, we have all broken God's commandments, and the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is everlasting life through Jesus Christ. Christ paid the penalty in full on the cross. He shed his blood for the remission, for the forgiveness of all our sins, past, present, and future. He was buried, but on the third day he rose again from the dead. When you believe that truly in your heart, call upon Jesus, you will be saved, and your name shall be written in heaven. Save yourself from this wicked, untoward generation. Believe on Jesus' death, his burial, and resurrection, and call upon him. The hour is very late. The Antichrist is about to make his appearance on the world stage. The Antichrist will cause all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in their right hand or in their foreheads. Without the mark of the beast, you will not be able to sell. But once you take the mark of the beast, that's it. Game over. You will spend eternity in the lake of fire. Jesus does not want that. He wants you in heaven. And the only requirement is to believe the gospel that Christ paid the penalty in full on the cross for all our sins, past, present, and future. He was buried, but on the third day, he rose again from the dead. You believe that truly in your heart and call upon Jesus, and you will be saved. Do not take the gamble that heaven and hell are not real, because they are. Your body contains your soul, which will spend eternity in one of two places, heaven or hell, and the choice is yours. Please make the right choice. Choose Jesus. He said, I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. No man shall see the Father in heaven but through Jesus. Jesus Christ said, I am the door. By me, if any man shall enter in, he shall be saved. Any man. It doesn't matter what we have done. Jesus will receive each and every one of us who goes to him in truth. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, that whosoever believes on him should not perish, but have everlasting life. It's not about religion, it's simply believing on Jesus' death, his burial and resurrection on the cross, and calling upon him. Believe on Jesus' death, burial and resurrection in your heart, truly. Believe that he was raised to life on the third day. Believe that truly in your heart. Call upon Jesus, and your name shall be written in heaven, and you'll be safe from going down to hell. God wants each and every one of you in heaven, but he's given you a choice. He's given you free will. Will you make the right choice? Please, we beseech you, we implore you, let you go to your heavenly Father, who made you, who loves you, who knows you better than you know yourselves. Go to Jesus. He will not turn anyone away who goes to him. It's true. The Bible makes it expressly clear that we have all broken God's commandments. We have all sinned, and the wages of sin is death. But the gift of God is everlasting life through Jesus Christ. Christ paid the penalty in full on the cross for all our sins, past, present, and future. He was buried, and on the third day he rose again from the dead. Would you believe that truly in your heart and call upon Jesus? You will be saved. God made it so simple for a little child to understand. Jesus said, unless you become as little children and be converted, you will never enter the kingdom of heaven. Please listen to what I am saying. Please do not harden your hearts. God wants you in heaven. Christ died on the cross. He shed his blood for the forgiveness of all our sin, past, present, and future. He was buried, and on the third day he rose again from the dead. When you believe that truly in your heart and call upon Jesus, it is the only requirement for you to enter into heaven and to be safe from going down to hell. The Bible says in the last days, many mockers, many scoffers will come. People have hardened their hearts so much that they will not receive the gift of God, which he wants to give every one of you. The gift of God is everlasting life. But the wages of sin is death. God wants to give you his gift, and it's all down to you. It's all down to you. Will you believe on Jesus and what he did for you on the cross? He shed his blood for the remission, for the forgiveness of all our sins, past, present, and future. He was buried, and on the third day, he rose again from the dead. The only requirements for you to enter into heaven and be saved is believe on Jesus' death, his burial, and resurrection, and call upon the name of Jesus, and you will be saved. Please do not take the gamble that heaven and hell are not real, because they are. Jesus wants you in heaven. He doesn't want any to perish, for God did not send his son Jesus into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through Jesus might be saved. The hour is late, the night is far spent, and the day of Jesus is at hand. Lay hold of your salvation. Jesus said, I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. No man shall see the Father in heaven but through me. Go to Jesus. He will not turn anyone away who goes to him in truth.
Right, best stop that. It's been on 15 minutes. Please pray for the seeds that we've planted and the few people that have received the tracts. God bless.